Hello students, let's begin with the concept of opportunity cost today, which is in the first chapter of the textbook. So before we begin, if you look at any decision-making problem in real life, an individual is faced with different possible actions or alternatives. So now, when an individual chooses a particular course of action or a particular alternative, the individual is foregoing or not choosing several other remaining actions or alternatives. Okay, so now the question is, now any alternative or any action that brings a certain benefit to the individual, and there might be certain costs associated with it. So in the end, the question is that out of these actions or alternatives, what is the best that the individual can do? So that's a question, and to address that question, the notion of opportunity cost will be useful. So for instance, suppose we will give a more concrete example in a second, but let's, you know, try to understand it generally. So suppose the possible actions or alternatives available to an individual are, let's say, four possible actions, A, B, C, and D. So now when the individual chooses action A, the individual is giving up B, C, and D. Okay. So now the question is the choice of A better than B, C, and D? So first of all, we have to see out of B, C, and D, what would be the best. And then we compare A with that best action out of the race that the individual is giving up. Okay, so again, so suppose the possible actions are A, B, C, and D. If the individual is choosing A, then the person is giving up B, C, and D. Now, out of, this is an example with only four, and in real life, actually, there could be several possible actions. So out of these three that the individual is giving up, we have to see what is the best. gives up, or we can call it foregoes. That's one question. And the second question is, how does this, based out of, you know, several others that the individual is giving up, how does it compare with A? Okay, so that is, now when we do this, this comparison, this is where the notion of opportunity cost will be useful. The opportunity cost is actually, it quantifies the potential benefits that the individual gives up when the individual chooses a specific action. So opportunity cost quantifies the potential benefits from, you know, B, C, and D, and out of B, C, and D, whatever is the best. So that action gives certain benefits. This will be more clear when we look at an example. So that the individual is giving up when the individual is choosing the action A. So opportunity cost quantifies that the potential benefits that the individual is giving up. And of course, action A, it also brings certain benefits. So then it becomes a comparison that this is what the person is giving up to when it chooses the action A, and this is what it gets from action A. Now, how does it compare? Now, what it gets from A, if it is better than what it gives up, then certainly it is good to choose A. However, what it gives up, if it is better than the action A, then it won't be a wise choice to carry out the action A. Okay, so that's how the opportunity cost is useful. So if potential benefits So if potential benefits from the best action out of the three, B, C, and D, if this is higher than A, then of course it won't be a wise choice to carry out action A. However, if this is lower than A, if from what it is giving up, if that is lower than A, then it will be a wise choice to carry out action A. Okay, so that is the notion of opportunity cost, that we have a decision making problem. It can be a problem of how to spend time, how to use time, that can be a problem for an individual, a specific amount of time. For a company, the problem could be where to make an investment. Okay. For a worker, the problem could be what kind of skill to acquire. For a student, the problem could be, you know, what are the subjects that I should study. So in general, in all of these problems, there are many possible alternatives. And when an individual chooses a particular action or alternative, the individual is giving up several other options. So then the question is it a wise choice to make that, to choose that specific action? There, the notion of opportunity cost will be useful. Okay, so again, just to give some examples, as I mentioned. So suppose we have a certain amount of time, we have like 5 hours that we can, you know, we can work, we can study, we can go out and so on. So there again, we have a problem that there is a certain amount of time. What is the best possible use of the time? Second, you know, the example that we gave, that for a worker has, you know, limited time and limited amount of money to spend. So suppose a worker wants to learn a new skill. Okay, so then the question is, should I study skill A or skill B? Should I learn computer or should I learn something else? And so on. So there the problem would be, what skill to acquire? And there are many possible different alternatives. Then the third example is, suppose a company has a specific amount of capital, then there the question is where to make this investment. Should it invest in an area where it already has some market share, or should it invest in a new good, and so on. Okay, so that one can think of many examples. So let's look at a numerical example from the book, chapter 1 of the book. This is the problem of allocation of time.